Now, ever since the time our last honoree fastened two ping pong balls to one of his mother's old green coats, created a puppet called Kermit the Frog. And the beloved characters he created have charmed the young and young at heart the world over. A lot of people think he coined the term puppet to describe his unique combination of marionette and foam rubber hand puppets, but the truth is, the sound of the word just tickled him. As an Emmy award-winning television producer and Oscar-nominated film director, this puppeteer, storyteller, and visionary created a global phenomenon called The Muppets. But it wasn't the way Jim changed how a puppet appeared within the television frame or how he gained a wider range of emotion by re-envisioning the way a puppet was constructed or articulated. And it isn't just the television shows, movies, and special appearances he made throughout his career that we remember him for. Jim had a rare gift for knowing how to make us feel. Like Walt, he was a small town boy who took something considered simple and limited in appeal, animation and puppetry, and elevated them to art forms that could charm fans of all ages. Whether it was Statler and Waldorf dishing their furry compatriots, or Oscar the Grouch, Cookie Monster, Big Bird, Bert, and the rest of the gang breaking us up with a look or the delivery of a perfectly paced line, the Muppets became part of our families. Luckily for us, the indelible Muppets legacy lives on here at the Walt Disney Company, as well as through the Jim Henson Company, Jim Henson Foundation, and Jim Henson's Creature Shop. The Muppets will light up the big screen once again this coming November in a Walt Disney Studios release. I would now like to introduce someone with far more inside knowledge into the life of Jim Henson. Please welcome his daughter, Lisa Henson.
Good morning. Thanks so much for including us Hensons in this special day. Heather Henson's also here, my daughter Ginger, and Brian Henson, as you'll see. I'm often asked what it was like to grow up with Jim Henson as my father. And did he perform Kermit at the dinner table? No. Did he include us in his work? Yes, very much. And did I grow up in a creative home? Definitely. The other question I'm regularly asked is, who was your favorite Muppet? It's a difficult question to answer since every character has a personality that has some sort of universal truth to it. But in the end, my answer is always the same. My favorite Muppet is Ralph the dog. Like Kermit, Ralph was originally performed by my dad. And like Kermit, Ralph has a personality that in some ways is a reflection of my dad's own personality. And in addition to being the first Muppet celebrity, thanks to his appearances on the Jim Henson Show, Ralph also represents a certain time in my father's career. He's a reminder of the early days of my father's work, when the company consisted of just a few talented artists and writers, like Jerry Jewell, Don Salmon, Frank Oz, and of course my mother, Jane Henson, who would go on to be the founding members of a team led by Jim Henson that would create the brilliant and irreverent Muppets. And that team grew along with my father's vision to create groundbreaking projects like The Muppet Show, Fraggle Rock, The Dark Crystal, and Labyrinth. Muppets were always a team effort, and not just one man's vision. And I am so grateful to that team today because I know it was this group's strength and talent and craft that allowed the Muppets to continue after my father's passing. And my father once said, when I was young, my ambition was to be one of the people who made a difference. My hope is to leave the world a little bit better for having been here. I've always loved that quote. The greatest honor for an artist is to have his creation live on beyond his own lifetime, to continue to be meaningful to generations to come. I believe my father would be thrilled to receive this honor and to share it with his collaborators, and know that his creations have lived on and will continue to do so. So, thank you.
Mr. Jim Henson.
Jim Henson. I created the Muppet.
What do you think, Duffy?
It's certainly not a career that one would want.
I heard of a TV station was looking for a puppeteer. I was in high school at the time. So I made a couple of puppets and auditioned and got a job. And that's kind of how it all started. And they gave us a little 5-minute show that was late at night. It was on at 11:30. Back in the early days, it was my wife, Jane. And then the group slowly began to grow. Jerry Jewell joined us. I did a lot of commercials in those days.
Now what do you think, Logan?
Then I moved up to New York.
Frank Oz joined us. Frank was just a kid at the time.
And started working on the Jimmy Dean show. Was Ralph the Doro. Then we did the Ed Sullivan show.
From the Ed Sullivan Theater on Broadway,
this is Jim Henson.
And you're watching Sesame Street.
I've always loved the show. I've loved to be a part of it from the very beginning. And television is such a huge influence on children. It's an influence on all of us, of course. And it's a lot of fun.
I guess the puppet show is sort of the next thing that, it's running through history here. We did 120 shows. They were wonderful to do. It was one of my favorite times. During that time, a lot of characters happened. As you know, Piggy sort of came out of the airport. From a creative standpoint, it's a lot more interesting to change and do something different and new. So we've always sort of kept moving and then changing and not staying too long in one area. The whole idea was to create an entire world that was not this world. I love Disneyland. It's like one of my very favorite places, Disneyland and Disney World. I think it's so beautifully done.
On behalf of all Muppets, I just want to say how happy we are to be part of the Disney family.
No way!
Put it up with your music, quality ball! Yay! Today we all went to Disneyland. He guarded the gate and didn't want to let us out.
It's good things about people who can do Jim Henson's job. He'll be with us every time they watch the Muppets.
There's no feeling inside that feeling. Together.
Second nature to me now.
Show was actually shot at 7:15. But he had this wonderful infectious energy that just spread to everybody that worked around him. And when you see him in interviews and stuff, he's often very sober and sincere, but when you work with him, he was one of the lightest, most wonderful men you can imagine. And he would be so honored now to receive this kind of honor from the Jim Henson Company, from the Walt Disney Company. He was, I don't even know what that means, but I just did that. He really was a huge fan of Disney, of Walt Disney, and the theme parks particularly, and we went and visited the theme parks many times with him, right up till, you know, always as an adult, and we all went with him, even as adults. And that was always what he felt was about the most wonderful thing in the world, were the Disney theme parks. And so this is a really wonderful honor for him, and thank you from the Henson family.
Present you the Disney Legends Award. Now I'm really honored to present you the Disney Legends Award for legendary contributions in film and television, awarded to your father, Chip.
And the dog have in common?
No, I don't.
Well, I think it's that guy up here.
Who's that guy?
You know this one?
You start.
Okay. Why are there so many
songs
about rainbows for everyone? What's on the other side? Okay.
Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. And rainbows have nothing to hide.
Wow, shows what you know. So we've been told, and some chose to believe it. Nice. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Sing with me.
Okay.
Someday we'll find it. The rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Very nice.
Thank you.
Why don't you take one?
All right. Who says that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star?
Somebody just for that. And someone believe in what it's done so far.
Someone needs that you just start gazing. Now what do we think we might say? I should be looking at the lyrics. Someday we'll find it. The rainbow connection. The lovers. The dreamers can be all of us under its spell. We know that it's probably magic.
Everybody sing along!
In half asleep and have heard voices, I've heard them calling my name. Can you hear them? Is this
the sweet sound that calls the young sailor? The voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be.
Yeah!
Take it all!
Something.
the 2011 Disney Legends Award Ceremony, I'd like to personally congratulate all the new Disney Legends. It's a remarkable group. Thanks to everyone. We hope you enjoy the rest of your weekend here at the D23 Expo. Good night.